Hello everyone and a very good evening to you. Thank you very much indeed for joining me for this organ recital given on the magnificent organ of St Bavokerk in Haarlem. This three-manual Müller organ is wonderful. It's sensational. The music tonight is mostly Baroque music, which this organ does rather well, unsurprisingly. We will start tonight with Dietrich Buxtehude. And this is his Preludium in G minor, BuxWV 148. Starts off with this Fantasia idea before going into a fugue on a really rather quirky registration before segueing into another fugue and then ending with a chaconne. It's really rather good actually, and you'll enjoy it. This organ makes it sound wonderful. I do hope you like it. This is Buxtehude.
Thank you.
It just makes you wonder where Bach would have been without the great influence of Buxtehude. He was undoubtedly a wonderful sort of mentor, if you like, and great influencer for J.S. Bach. And you can really tell that Buxtehude's music feeds through into Bach's music. It's very similar in style and excitement. That's a wonderful piece. I hope you liked it. This next piece by Scheidemann is a chorale prelude, if you like, on Erbarm dich mein, O Herr Gott. Have mercy upon me, O God. This is a more reflective piece, which allows me just to use some of the quieter stops on this wonderful organ. We will be using the clarinet upon the swell coupled down to the pedal with the tremulant, accompanied by the flute on the hoofed work. And then you'll have to see what we have for verse two. So there are actually two verses, both of which are harmonized. So Erbarm dich mein, O Herr Gott by Scheidemann. Thank you. Isn't that beautiful? This next piece is, I wouldn't say it was beautiful, I would say it's tricky, exciting, thrilling, and J.S. Bach at his cheekiest. It is the Prelude and Fugue in D major, 5-3-2, with the famous opening pedal scale. And this just has so much energy about it, and I don't know of another piece by Bach or by any other composer, particularly when it comes to the fugue, anything like this really. I think it's very unique, very exciting, and actually just all very positive and happy. It's one of those sort of pieces where you can imagine him showing off and playing it and just, and almost just, yeah, well, what? You know, I can just imagine that. It is wonderful. It is, it sounds wonderful on this organ, and I think you'll rather enjoy this. This is the Prelude and Fugue in D major by Bach, BWV 532. It is, it's fair to say, a relief when you get to the end of that fugue. because I think, you know, the whole thing is rather fiddly. You may have noticed that. But the hardest bit is probably at the end. The most exposed bit is at the end, the very end of the piece. So you spend the entire time waiting for that pedal solo. And it's wonderful fun. Wonderful for us, all toes. So isn't that a jolly piece? That's wonderful, isn't it? Wonderful. It works really well on this organ. We will actually now just, when this organ was built, there wasn't any modern technology, you know, any electric or anything like that. But with the help and aid of modern technology, and keeping my fingers crossed that this works, I'm actually going to incorporate Caroline into this recital now. She's actually in the other room, monitoring the chat, talking to you guys, keeping you under control, and actually doing some of the angles as well. So I hope she's been changing them. I hope it's all working. Please do let us know if everything is okay. I'm sure you have already. But I've actually we have already recorded some music. She's singing the plain song to this next piece. This is the a piece by Samuel Scheidt. It's his Magnificat actually, and it's based on a plain song tone. You'll hear Caroline singing it, but it goes, the tone is like this. So verse one is Magnificat anima mea et exaltavit spiritus meus. That's obviously, you know, the wonderful words to the Magnificat. Verse one is sung by Caroline. Verse two is played by me et exaltavit. Verse three is sung by Caroline. Verse four by me. So we actually alternate the words and the music. So listen out for Caroline singing this. Get used to the tone, to the plain song idea, and then listen to it in the organ part to see how Scheidt harmonizes it, varies it, and brings color and life to it. So fingers crossed this works. This is Samuel Scheidt's Magnificat, intoned by Caroline.
Meus.
Hope that worked okay. Thank you very much to Caroline for doing that in advance. Really effective, I think, having the plain song tone sung in between each of those variations. Excuse me. So that was a wonderful piece by Samuel Scheidt, the Magnificat. Now we'll actually have a little bit of a curveball. We're just going to step away from Baroque music for a minute into something which I heard. I only heard this recently on a recording by John Scott, the late John Scott, one of my organist heroes. On the organ, on an organ, on a Manda organ in New York. You have to excuse me, I can't actually remember which church it is now. But he plays this, and it just really struck me. It just has this sense of, there are no time signatures, so it has the sense of just infinite endlessness. Not in a bad way, it has direction. And it doesn't really have a key either. But it always seems to be anchored down by some pedal notes going towards sort of E minor. It feels like E minor, a modal version of E minor, but not quite, because you'll see what I mean. It doesn't stay in E minor at all, but it feels to be anchored. And it reminds me of a one of the movements from La Nativité by Messiaen. I wonder actually whether you can identify which movement I'm thinking of. Now, this is a piece by Guy Bovet, and it's called Ricercare. I think that's pronounced right. It's Italian, Ricercare, rather than Ris. I'm sure you'll correct me if I'm wrong. And it's really wonderful. He actually asks for a few flutes, and if you really must, have a quiet 8 and 4. But actually, I've kept it to the, I've got 3 flutes, one on each manual. And it's wonderful, at the very end he says, and this is translated from the French, we can finish in minor or major at will. So I'll see how the mood takes me. This is a wonderful piece. I really hope you enjoy it. Give it a chance. It just has this wonderful sense of, well, you decide. You in the chat, bring some words, type some words that come to mind. So Ricercare by Guy Bovet. Thank you. I often think music is at its best when it's at its most simple. Just using three flutes and a 16 and an 8 foot on the pedal was all that piece required. And I just hope that you took something from that. I hope you were able just to maybe contemplate or meditate throughout the course of it. I really like that piece. I'll play it again. Maybe I'll record it properly. Okay, so we'll now go back to Bach for a real Baroque banger, you might say. This is the Prelude and Fugue in A minor, BWV 543. What to say about this, really? This is a new piece to me. I only learned this piece a matter of months ago. We are now in November, and this was new to me probably over the summer this year. And I was always very daunted about it. I was always very daunted about the fugue, particularly. The subject of the fugue is actually rather just tricky to get your head around the rhythm. Because in the second half here, I just grew up thinking that the strong beat was on the second note. Like that. A little bit like. But so playing it, I just have to get rid of all of that. The strong beat comes. Once you've got around that, actually, it's the fugue isn't too bad. But that took me a long time to get to teach my mind the rhythm, undo all of those wrong habits, bad habits of my teenage years. So, I will stop talking and let the music do the talking. Prelude and Fugue in A minor by Bach, BWV 543 on the wonderful, magnificent organ in. St Bavokerk in Haarlem. Recorded, by the way, by Voxus Virtual Organs. Check these guys out, check their website out. They're doing wonderful stuff, and I'm very, very happy to play their organs on my channel. Isn't that just such a fantastic piece? It's really wonderful to play. It's one of those, you know, Bach, I find Bach to be really fulfilling when playing Bach, particularly those sorts of preludes and fugues, those famous ones. Really exciting to play, and it's such a reward to play them, particularly on this marvellous instrument. You know what? Bach just sounds so good on this organ that I'd like to just do one more piece by Bach. It will be the famous Sinfonia from Cantata number 29, Wir danken dir Gott. We thank thee, O God, and the arrangement is by Marcel Dupre. Who else would it be? If you have donated tonight, thank you so much. It does mean a lot. And more importantly, it goes a very long way to help build the channel and to sustain the channel. If you can become a Patreon, have a look at the website. We have over 200 people, very supportive and friendly people who offer me advice and feedback. It's a wonderful community. Have a look over on patreon.com/beautyandsound. But thank you very much, everyone, for joining me tonight. I would like to play this one last piece to you, because it is so much fun, and this wonderful organ just does this music so well. So this is Wir danken dir Gott, the Sinfonia from that cantata, BWV 29, arranged by Marcel Dupre. Do you see what I mean about it being like a French toccata? The right hand just has all of that movement, all of those dotted staccato semiquavers. It's rather relentless, and it's actually rather tiring. I can imagine it being very hard work on one of the like the Cavaille Collins Sattel piece that Marcel Dupre was so used to. Very heavy action. I can imagine it being very hard work indeed. But what a terrific piece. I do hope that you've enjoyed this largely, mostly Baroque recital, apart from the Bovet that was a spanner in the works. I do hope that you enjoyed that. I think that's a wonderful piece. Please let me know in the comments if you like, if you've enjoyed this video. I'm sure you've done that in the live chat already, but I'd really appreciate a comment on the video and a like as well. That would be terrific. If you are able to become a Patreon, that would be amazing. That would help the channel so much, and it will help push it forward and ultimately to bring you a more amazing content, even better content. If you can't become a Patreon, please do consider making a donation. Thank you all so much. Tomorrow is virtual church, 5 o'clock UK time. It is Christ the King, so get your requests in related to Christ the King. And if you want any organ voluntaries as well, please let me know. I'll consider them all. Whether I can play them or not is a different matter. So until tomorrow, usual time, I will say cheerio. Thank you to Caroline again for her doing her no doubt wonderful angles and chatting with you guys, keeping you under control. Cheerio, until tomorrow, 5 o'clock. Good night, everyone. Bye-bye.